Hello people, let's see in this video how to apply effects with FL Studio 12. Leave us comments to improve our next videos. Effects are plugins used to edit the way you can hear sound in output. All the effects available are all listed in the browser panel inside Effects in Plugin Database. Effects can be added through the mixer window on each single pattern or mixer channel, including the master one. It is usually better to define all your pattern channels inside the mixer first, right-clicking on the insert channels and then going to channel routing. In this way, you can easily recognize which pattern channel the mixer channel is representing. Effects are added through the 10 slots on the extreme right of each mixer channel. Each slot welcomes one effect. Of course, if effects are added to the master channel, the whole output will be affected by such effects. To add an effect to the mixer channel selected, choose one slot and select the effect from the list. Effects are applied in order, from the first slot to the 10th one. The effect added will be represented with its name on the slot and its respective window opens, used to edit and find the effect settings. Close this window if you don't need it. You can open it again clicking on its slot. More on the right, you can turn on and off the green light to enable or disable the respective effect. This is quite useful to check the channel before and after such effect. You also have the mix level knob that sets how much effect you want to have in output. If its level is zero, the channel is dry or original in output. If the knob is at its maximum level, the channel is wet, so you hear in output just the edited channel without any original part. To change the effect added, click on the white arrow on the left, go to Replace and then choose a new plugin. Choose None to remove the effect from the slot instead. The plugins can really vary and apply different effects on the sound. Let's see the main kinds of effects you can apply. Effects are collected in different groups. The second group, under Delay Reverb, is used to apply delays and reverb. The delay effect repeats a channel in output, like an echo. You can use the Fruity Delay Bank and the Fruity Delay tool. The reverb effect is an echo very similar to a sound reflection from rooms, metals and environment. This is great when applied on sick beats, like kicks and snares. You can use Effector, Fruity Reverb 2 and the Fruity Convolver. Fruity Convolver can also edit the sound waveform used to realize the echo. You can also put delays between the stereo channels, for example with Fruity Stereo Shaper and Fruity Stereo Enhancer. The third group applies a distortion effect. This changes the original sound waveform, making it different. This effect is described through the out-in graph. The line represents for each dB level of the input or original waveform, the intensity of the output waveform. For example, if the line starts straight and then becomes flat, it means that the original components that are lower in volume reach the output as they are, while the most powerful and original waveforms are cut in output. You can add the distortion effect through different plugins, like Fruity Fast Dist, Fruity Soft Clipper, and the Fruity Wave Shaper. Also, Fruity Squeeze is good. This one does not use an out-in graph. The fourth group of plugins is dedicated to the sound dynamics. This collects tools used to compress or limit the channel interested, in order to improve its sound and avoid distortion and saturation. If you want to know how to improve your project sound, check out the related video in this guide. The fifth group lists the filters. The filters do cut or enhance the frequency components of the channel interested in the way you like. One of the best plugins that adds a filter is called the Fruity Parametric EQ2. This shows all the sound frequencies that people can hear, from 20 Hz to 20 kHz, a system called Spectrum. The intensity of each frequency is highlighted from red, low, to yellow, high. The filter is what to use to edit a channel spectrum. In this particular plugin, you can add 7 filters in total, from the number 1 to 7. Each can be pulled up or down, changing the main line that represents the overall filter gain, frequency by frequency. If you pull up a number, you will increase the filter gain on that point, and the frequency components that fall there will become more intense. Vice versa, you will cut them if you pull down the number. In this way, you can create a low-pass filter that treats the lowest frequencies, a band-pass that treats the mid-frequencies, and a high-pass for the highest frequencies. The filter is not described through its gain only. It has also a central frequency or position and a bandwidth that sets the width of the filter gain. You can adjust the central frequency and bandwidth through the knobs on the right. Mind that it is shown in such graph the spectrum of the signal that has all the effects that are placed in higher slots respect to the filter plugin. The mixer itself has a filter that can be applied to the channel, called equalizer, in the bottom right corner. You can also use Fruity Parametric EQ, equo, or the Fruity Low filter, which is the most professional one. Under Flanger, you find all effects to edit your waveform without distorting it too much. For example, the chorus effect is used to make a channel a union of more channels playing at the same time. You can realize this through the Fruity Chorus plugin. The other kind of effect is the flange one, that consists in overlapping the original sound with one or more identical waveforms, but phase shifted in time, changing sound a little in output. This is done by the Fruity Flanger, the Fruity Flangus, and the Fruity Phaser. These are the main effects you can add in FL Studio 12, but there are other plugins, more advanced, that can be quite useful as well. Let's see the most important ones. Pitcher is a plugin that changes the tone of a channel, quite useful especially for speech channels, to adjust their tone and pitch. Another great plugin is the Edison one. This is not an effect plugin, but is a sample editor, really great to extract the channel waveform and edit it. While the channel is being played, you can record it through the record button inside Edison and extract its sound waveform in the graph below. You can then playback it through the player on top and select parts of the waveform, double-clicking on it and dragging. Right-click on the selected part and go to Edit to modify it. In case you mistake, use the Undo button on top. Mind that this can undo just your latest action. Then, when you are done, you can extract the final waveform outside FL Studio, clicking on the first icon from the left and going to Save Sample As. Through the other buttons inside Edison, you can also add other effects like reverb, volume fading, pitch, and so on. A similar plugin is called Newtone. This works with sound waveforms, as seen inside Edison, but with more advanced effects, especially to change the tone and the sound pitch. But in this case, you are not able to record and import directly from FL the waveform to start editing. So you have to import the sound file from your computer first. Just click on the floppy button and go to Load Sample. The waveform imported appears on a sort of piano roll. Drag and move the waveform up or down to change its tone. Drag from its edges to warp the waveform. The warping effect consists in changing the waveform length without changing its pitch. Once the editing is done, just export it using Save Sample As to use it inside your project. Another great plugin is called Grossbeat. This changes the playing speed of the channel it is applied to. On the right, you have a graph representing one full bar. The channel is at its original speed when the green line is flat. You can edit this through its points, dragging them and adding new ones right-clicking on the line. An increasing line is a time acceleration, so the channel is played faster and it will have higher frequency components. If it goes decreasing, the channel will be played slower. Thanks for watching this video. Check out our full guide to learn more for FL Studio 12.